So, this yoga system, bhakti yoga, how to increase attachment for Krishna is being taught by our Krishna consciousness movement. Maya saptamana prartha yugang junyan madhasra. In this connection, one has to learn this yogic system from Krishna directly or from his representative. That is the meaning of madhasra. One must take shelter either. So at the present moment, it is not possible to take shelter of Krishna directly. Therefore, one has to take shelter of his bona fide representative. And there are four parties or sampradaya who are Vaishnavas. The Brahma Sampradaya, Rudra Sampradaya, Sri Sampradaya, and Kumar Sampradaya. So one has to take shelter of either of these Sampradaya, disciplic succession, and then learn the Bhakti Yoga system from him. Then he will understand, or he will see God. Seeing God is not exactly seeing with the eyes. God's another name is Anubhav, realization, revelation, realization. So that is wanted. That revelation is made by Krishna himself to the bona fide devotee. Sevan mukhi hi jivado swameva spurattada. Krishna, God reveals himself. Just like you cannot see the sun in the darkness of night. Sun is there in the sky. But somehow or other, when your planet is on the other side and it is darkness, you cannot see the sun. Not that the sun is not there, but you cannot see. Similarly, Krishna is always present before us, but we cannot see him. Just like Krishna, when was personally present, There are so many hundreds and millions of men on the surface of the globe. Only few could see him, that he is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So even God, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna comes before somebody, it is not possible to see him. The seeing process is different. Premanjana churita bhakti vilochanena. One can see when the eyes are anointed with the ointment of bhakti. When the eyes are cleansed to see God. That is revelation. It is said that a pure devotee is seeing Krishna every moment. Shanta sadaiva. Sadaiva means every moment. He is seeing. But that means he is a different person. His senses are purified, electrified, sanctified. Therefore he is seeing. And one's eyes, if not sanctified, purified, then he cannot see. There are so many examples. That's like a machine. A child is seeing. but he cannot see properly. He sees a lump of matter. But an engineer, when he sees, he immediately understands that this machine is made by such and such, it is working for this, a good machine, bad machine, nice. He can see in different way because he has got the eyes to see. Similarly, to understand Krishna, God, we require to purify our senses. That is defined by Narad Pancharatra. Sarvapadhi vinir muktam. Being freed from all kinds of designation. Just like we are seeing Krishna consciousness, accepting Krishna consciousness in a vision, and somebody else, ordinary man, suppose somebody is in Christian, he sees Krishna consciousness as a movement of the Hindus. But actually it is not. Therefore, he has to become free from the designation of becoming an American. Sarvapadhi vinir muktam. One should be free from the designation. Like, this body is a designation. Actually, there is no difference between American body and Indian body. The same physiological construction. There is blood, there is flesh, there is bone. If you see within the body, there is no difference. But still, we have designated. I am American, you are Indian, you are black, I am white, and this and that. These are all designations. False. So one has to become free from the designation. That is defined that when we are freed from the designation. Sarvapadhi vinir muktam. One should be freed from the designation. Actually, designation has no value. The person is important, not the designation. So, to see Krishna means first business is to become free from the designation. Sarvapadhi vinir muktam. Tatparatena nirmalam. Here it is said matpara and Narada says tatpara. Tatpara means to become Krishnaized. And matpara means, Krishna says, you become matpara. Intensely absorbed in me. And the devotee says, intensely absorbed in Krishna. That is it. But actually the aim is the same. So one has to become designated free and intensely in Krishna. Sarvapadhi vinir muktam matparatsana. Then he'll be nirmal. Nirmal means purified, without any material contamination. I am thinking in terms of my bodily concept of life, that is material, because the body is material. So long I am thinking I am American, I am Indian, I am Brahmin, I am Kshatri, I am this, I am that, they are all designations. That is not nirmalam, purified condition. Purified condition is when one understands that I am spirit soul, Krishna is the supreme spirit soul, and I am part and parcel of Krishna. We are one in quality. We may be different as individual. Krishna is big individual. I am a small individual. Just like in this material world also, one man is very powerful, another man is less powerful, but both of them are men. They are not animals. Similarly, Krishna, God, is qualitatively one with me. Quantitatively, he is very, very powerful.